Hi friends, Rebecca Murray here with part 4 of the Breast Cancer Chronicles. And as you might recall, last week we were talking about the actual operation, and I promised to share with you a complication that a small percentage of women have post-op, and I was experiencing, still am experiencing that. So here's where the complication arises. My surgeon, I remember in our first discussion where I decided to go through with the mastectomy, explained all the risks to me. And one of those risks was that a small percentage of women experience what is called nipple necrosis. Sounds pretty bad. Basically, it's sort of like a frostbite effect because your skin, think about this, the surgery. So you have this layer of skin, this thin layer of skin that's been sitting on all this fat, blood vessels, nerves, feeding it, keeping it nice and supple and alive. And now the surgeons just stripped that away, as much of the breast tissue as possible, leaving this fragile layer of skin. Well, it's right after the surgery, this breast skin turned a horrible deep purple color, I mean, right off the bat. And so the plastic surgeon told me, he said, I could tell, you know, things were not looking good right after the surgery for my skin. So when I went in for my first post-op appointment, this is what they were very concerned was happening, because I had this big, oddly shaped area, let's say about the size of a sticky note, an average sticky note, that was deep, deep, dark purple. And if it turns black, then they know it's necrotic tissue. You have to go in for another surgery. They have to cut it out. You get this, you know, in my case, it would have been an interesting looking scar up the side, and I would have lost my nipple on this side. So it's a kind of wait and see thing. I went in to see the plastic surgeon, and he said, you know, it's not quite black. Let's just do this. Let's just leave it alone. Don't touch it, and give it some time to see if your body's going to heal. And what he was thinking might happen is that it turns into like a scab, and then that falls off. So this area for me has been getting smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller, and it looks like, I mean, it is that he was right, just waiting for it's been a month so far and it's still not done healing, but just, you know, sitting back and waiting for the body to take care of it has worked fine, and I'm very, very grateful. But had it worked the other way, you know, where I'd had to go in for another operation. Now remember, this side that this is happening on is not the side that had the cancer. That was this side. I decided to do this side, number one, for symmetry, number two, so I would never have to worry about breast cancer in this breast, never have another mammogram or biopsy, never go through any of that again. And so the temptation when I took a look, and when they told me that I might, you know, be losing my nipple and part of my skin on the side, temptation for me might have been like, you know, why didn't I just leave well enough alone, like Popeye? Leave well enough alone, leave well enough alone. I know me stuff and I'm smart enough to live well enough alone. Remember that from years and years ago. But I didn't do that. I didn't beat myself up, and I didn't say the what ifs and the regret and all that, because I made the decision. I knew that there was a risk. I had a great surgeon who explained all of that. I was willing to move forward anyway. Of course, I was thinking I would not be in that small percentage of women who would have that happen. But as I thought of it, I'm so grateful again, and just sort of in a mode of acceptance. Of accepting the outcome, because I had chosen that path. And if you choose a path and something happens, we all know there are risks in life. There's no point in looking back at the what ifs, at feeling regret. It's a waste of energy. It's a waste of brain space. It's just regret is, it's just a wasteful, worthless activity. And I'm not going to play in that pond, park, sandbox, whatever. So I just wanted to let you know that everything's healing up fine. And next week, what I wanted to share with you, yesterday I went in for what I call my first fill-up. And it was fascinating what I learned. I'm going to share a picture of you with you of the tools that they use to do what they do. And I think you'll find it very interesting too. Yeah, you'll definitely find it interesting. So we'll see you next week where we talk about the filling up process. This is along the journey of the reconstruction before I go into my second surgery, which will likely be end of February or sometime in March. All right, I hope this was helpful for you. Coming up next week, the Breast Cancer Chronicles number 5. Talk to you. And coming up, we'll see you next week for the Breast Cancer Chronicle number 5. We'll see you next week for the Breast Cancer Chronicles episode 5. Bye for now.